is tape number 1 from the Nectar of Devotion series, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded between October 20th and November 14th, 1972, India.
These activities are taken into account by a superior authority known as Daiva, or the authority of God. This Daiva is explained in the Bhagavad Gita as the prime cause of everything. And in the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is stated that a man takes his next body by Daiva Netrena, which means by the supervision of the authority of the Supreme. In an ordinary sense, Daiva is explained as destiny. Daiva supervision gives us a body selected from 8,400,000 forms. The choice does not depend on our selection, but is awarded to us according to our destiny.
So, material rasas that is being experienced in different types of body, that like somebody wants to taste fresh blood, flesh and blood. So he is given the next life a body like a tiger, like a other carnivorous animal, and he tastes very nicely blood and flesh. Nature gives all the facilities. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarva ahamkara vimuratma kartaham iti mannade. Prakriti, nature, is doing everything. I am desiring something, that means I am contacting the certain type of the modes of material nature. This is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Karanam gunasanga asya sadasad janma jonish. Sad asad janma joni. Joni means the source of birth. Mother is called joni and father is called bija. Jatha joni, jatha bijam. According to bijam and according to joni, we get body. So why you are getting different types of body? Karanam gunasanga asya. He is contacting a particular type of the modes of material nature. There are three modes of material nature, satagun, rajagun, tamagun. So, if I am associating with satagun, then next life I will get a satagun body. Buddham gacchanti sattvastva. Satagun body means higher standard of life. So, similarly, if I am associating with the modes of passion, then I will get a body next life, passionate. If I am associating with ignorance, tamogun, jagannā guna-vrittiṣṭha adho-gacchanti tamasa. Tamasa, tamavritti, the jagannā, the lowest. There are so many varieties of life. So those who are associating with tamagun, drinking, flesh-eating, smoking, illicit sex, gambling, these are the association of tamagun. Yatra papas chaturvidha, where there are four kinds of sinful activity. So intoxication is sinful activity. That is tamagun, associating with tamagun. तो जघन्य गुणवृत्तिस्य अधोगच्छन्ति तामसा दोज आर एसोसिएटिंग विद तामोगुण देयर वृत्ति देयर हैबिट्स आर वेरी एबोमिनेबल जघन्य देयरफॉर अधोगच्छन्ति दे गो डाउनवर्ड्स इन दिस वे एवरीवन इज एंजॉयिंग ए पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ रसा material rasa, and nature is offering him a particular type of body. Deha yogena dehinam, we can enjoy a particular type of rasa, just like the hogs, they are relishing the rasa of stool very nicely. You give them nice food, they will not take. They will prefer to test the stools. Why? Because he has been offered a particular type of body. And this particular type of body has been offered to him karanam gunasangasya. He has associated with jaghanna tamagun, abominable tamagun. Therefore he has developed a body of a hog and tasting the juice of stool. This is the way of transmigration of the soul. Actually, it is the living spirit soul, either hog or dog or a brahmin, or a chandala, or a cow. This is simply a covering, just like we cover ourselves in dream. That is subtle covering. Similarly, this is also covering. In the Vedas it is said, asangāyam purusha. Actually, the living entity, the spirit soul, is neither hog, neither dog, nor brahmin, nor this, nor that. It is simply a covering. But this covering is developed by our association with the particular type of modes of nature. Karanam gunasanga sadasat janma jonishu. But in this life, if we develop Krishna consciousness by association of devotees, as Narottam Das Thakur has sung, Tadero Charana Sevi Bhaktasane Bhavas. One's aim of life should be to serve the acharyas, acharya upasanam. So, our acharya in the Gauriya Vaishnava Sampradaya, the Siddhu Sanatana Bhatta Raghunath, Sriji Gopala Bhatta Dasa Raghunath, the six Goswamis, and if we associate with them, this book, Nectar of Devotion, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, if you read regularly, try to understand, this means you are associating with Srila Rupa Goswami directly. And if you act accordingly, then you are serving their lotus feet. Tadero Charano Sevi. Bhakta Sanivas, and unless you are associated with devotees, you will not be able to understand the import of the writings of Srila Rupa Goswami. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's secretary, Sri Sarup Damodar, recommended one Brahmin, Bhagavat Paragya Bhagavata Sthane. Bhagavat, he came to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to read some poetry he had written, but it was the system that unless anything written There are many devotees. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was living at Puri, Jagannath Puri. So many devotees from other provinces used to come and visit, and some of them wrote some poetry. But all of them, first of all, would be tasted by Swarup Damodar. And then he will be allowed to go before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and read it. That was Krishna. Because people do not know Siddhanta, generally. Those who are advanced devotees, they know Siddhanta, the conclusion. In the Chaitanya Charitamrita, therefore, it has been advised, Siddhanta boliya chitte nakaro alas, iha haite krishne lage sudhiya mana. If you neglect Siddhanta, conclusion given by the acharyas, then you will misunderstand Krishna. Krishna, therefore, Narottamdas Thakur says, these are the evidences. Ruparaghunatha pade hoibe akuti kabe hamo bujhavase jugale pili. Narottamdas Thakur, such an exalted acharya, he is teaching us, don't try to understand jugala piriti. The love affairs between Radha and Krishna concocted by your own concoction. No. You should first of all try to serve the six Goswamis. Rupa Raghu Natapade Hai Vyas. How they are directing. Just like this Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Srila Rupa Goswami is not teaching in the beginning the loving affairs of Radha Krishna. No. He's training, first of all, the reader, the devotee. How to become, first of all, pure devotee? Anna vilasita sundam jnana karmadana abhritam anukullena krishna anusilanam bhakti uttama. First of all, he is trying to bring the devotee to the standard devotional service, vidhimarga. Then gradually, when he becomes accustomed, then raga-marga will be revealed. Raga-marga is not artificial. It becomes sāveva-spurattala. Sevan-mukhihi-jivhādhos, everything. Devotional relationship with Krishna, you cannot establish artificially. Everyone has got a particular relationship with Krishna in his original constitutional position. That will be revealed gradually as you advance in devotional service, in the prescribed rules and regulations as they are directed in the Shastra and by spiritual master. When you are trained up properly, you come to the platform of raga-marga, then your relationship, that is called sarup-siddhi. Sarup-siddhi. So sarup-siddhi is attained at a certain stage. Just like sarup-siddhi, a desire for sex life is there in every human being. But when the boy and the girl come to the mature state, it becomes manifest. It is not learned artificially. Similarly, the raga-marga sarup-siddhi becomes revealed or manifest. Sabanadi suddha chitte karoye udar. Udar, this very word, udar is used just like sun. Sun becomes visible when the sun rises automatically. You cannot force the sun to rise at dead of night. That is not possible. Sun will rise. You just wait. When the time will be right. Morning, 6 o'clock, it finds the sun. Similarly, the devotional service we have to execute with patience, with enthusiasm, with sahar, dhaijya, nishaya, tattva-karma-pravartana. We must be enthusiastic that I shall engage myself very nicely in Krishna consciousness movement. That is first qualification, enthusiasm. Dullness will not help you. You must be very enthusiastic. My Guru Maharaj used to say, pran ache jar sehetu pracha. A preacher can, a person can become a preacher if he has got life. A dead man cannot become a preacher. So, he must be very enthusiastic that I shall preach the glories of the Lord to my best capacity. It is not that one has to become very learned scholar to become a preacher. Simply, it requires enthusiasm. My Lord is so great, so kind, so beautiful, so wonderful. So I must speak something about my Lord. This is the qualification. Enthusiasm. You may not know Krishna very perfectly. It is not possible to know Krishna very perfectly. Krishna is unlimited. We cannot know Krishna 100%. That is not possible. But Krishna reveals as far as possible, you can understand. So, if you are sincere servant of Krishna, utsaha, and if you serve patiently, then Krishna reveals. The example is given in this connection, just like a girl is married. Generally, a girl wants a child, but if she wants a child immediately after marriage, that is not possible. She must wait. She must serve her husband nicely, usādhajya, tattva-karma-pravartana, just like a faithful wife. Time will come, she will become pregnant and she will have child. So, nishchayat means, just like the girl must know, because she is married, because she has got a husband, that there must be a child. It is a fact. It may be little later. Similarly, when you have entered into devotional service, bhakti yoga, bhakti marga, your success is assured, provided you are enthusiastic and patient. Not that immediately I want a child. Immediately I become fully Krishna consciousness and perfect. No. There may be so many imperfections, because we are in the imperfect atmosphere. But patiently, if you go on executing your duties in devotional service, as it is directed in the Shastras and confirmed by the spiritual master, then rest assured where your success is guaranteed. This is the way. Utsahat bhajyat tattat karma pravartana. You must execute the duty. Just like we have asked our student to finish 16 rounds chanting, minimum. 16 rounds is nothing. In Vrindavan there are many devotees, they chant 120 rounds, like that. The 16 rounds is the minimum, because I know in the Western country it is difficult job to finish 64 rounds or 120 rounds like that. Minimum 16 rounds. That must be finished. Tattva karma pravartana. This is the direction. Observing the regulative principle. In this way, we must be abiding by the direction of the spiritual master and the Shastra. Then rest assured, success is guaranteed. Go on living this.
If our body is friendly,
with the light.
If our body at present is engaged in the activities of Krishna consciousness, then it is guaranteed that we will at least have at least a human body in our next life.
So one thing is guaranteed. If you engage in Krishna consciousness, and suppose you do not become perfectly mature, somewhere or other you fall down. We should not fall down, because if you have got enthusiasm and patience, we shall not fall down. But suppose we fall down, Shastra says, Tasya abhadra abhut amushakim. There is nothing inauspicious. Because whatever you have done sincerely, that is recorded in the book, in the Krishna's book. Krishna has got accountant. He keeps nice account of the activities of his devotees. That's a fact. Just like the non-devotees' accounts are kept by Jamaraj for punishment. Similarly, devotees' accounts are kept by Krishna personally. Jija thamang prabhadante tangsta thayivamajammaham. Unless he keeps account, how he says, I respond to the devotee to the proportionate surrender. Jija thamang prabhadante. The real business is surrender to Krishna. If we surrender immediately 7%, then Krishna also gives you the result immediately, 7%. Krishna says, sarva dhanman paritajya mami kam saranam bhaja aham pa sarva papi bhama khosham. If Krishna relieves me from all kinds of sinful activities, then where is my miserable condition of life? Miserable condition of life is for them who are as enjoying or suffering. There is no question of enjoyment, but it is sometimes taken enjoyment. The fruitive action, the result of fruitive action. So a devotee does not enjoy anything or suffering, because a devotee does everything for Krishna. So therefore, for his personal self, there is no question of karma phala. That is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Yajñate karma annatra karma bandhana. If you act for Krishna, that is nice. If you act otherwise, then it is karma bandhana. Yajñate karma annatra. Annatra means except Krishna consciousness activities, the activities of the karmis and the jnanis and the yogis, they are all karma bandhana, bound up. Suppose karmis, they are going to the heavenly planet or higher planetary system for getting higher standard of life, to take birth, but pious activities, a nice family to become rich. But that is bandhana, that is bondage. Similarly, the so-called mukti, jnanis, they merge into the existence, Brahma existence, of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Nirbheda brahmanu sandha, nirbheda, without any distinction, enter, merge into the Brahma. That is also bandhana, bondage. Why? Because we find in the Shastra, Arujya kichena parama padama tata patanti adha. Arujya kichena parama padama. Parama padama means Brahma pad. To merge into the effulgence, Brahma Jyoti, that is called Parampara. According to Vaishnava Parampara means to go to Vaikuntha or Golok Vrindavan and be engaged as servant, eternal servant of the Lord. But according to the Jainis, the Parampara means merge into the effulgence or Brahma Jyoti. The Shastra says that Arujya Pichena Parampadam, to go to that Parampadam, that is also not very easy. Pichena, severe austerities and penances one has to undergo to merge into the Brahma effulgence. Therefore you will find the Mahabadi sannyasis, their stricture is very rigid. They must take bath thrice in a day and lie down underneath the tree. Their renunciation is very rigid. Of course, those who are strictly followed. In our Vaishnava sannyas, there is little leniency because they live in Krishna. So there is no need of very strict, rigid following, although it is stated that they should live like this. But there is leniency. But Mahabhag, they are very rigid in their principles of sannyas life. That is called Arujya Krichena, Krichena, with great difficulty. They merge into the Brahma Vipajan. Arujya Krichena Param Padam. They attain the perfectional stage, not perfectional, Param Padam, in the spiritual realm. But patanti adha, again falls down. Again falls down means because in the effulgence there is no variety. The example is just like you have got a nice Sputnik or what is called?
Apollo.
Apollo. No, by which they go? Rocket. You have got very nice rocket running at the speed of 18,000 miles or 25,000 miles per hour. But you may go if you don't get a shelter in some planet, that as they are going in the moon planet, but do not get shelter and come back. Similarly, supposing they are getting shelter, but that shelter is not very secure, they again come back. So, without shelter, how long you can fly in the sky? The sky is unlimited. You can fly on your Sputnik or capsule. But if you don't get this shelter in some planet, then again you come back to your plane. So this is the same example is given in the Bhagavad. Arujya Krichena, with great scientific method you can go up, but if you don't get a shelter, then you come back again on this planet. Similarly, the non-devotees, impersonalists, they undergo severe penances and austerities, undoubtedly, and they rise up to the Brahma Jyoti. Arujya Krichena Parang Padam. Tata Patanti Adha. From there, he again falls down. Same example. Why? Anadrita Jusmat Anghaya. Because they did not care for the shelter under the lotus feet of Krishna. Therefore, they have to come back again to this material world. That is practically experience. We have seen many, many great sannyasis. They give up this world and take sannyas for merging into Brahma. But later on, they come back again to the material activities for opening hospital, school and philanthropic work. Why? Because they could not get there. In their so-called Brahma realization, they could not get any pleasure. Therefore they come down again to the material activities. You have left this material world as Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya. Then why you come back again to this Mithya world to open hospitals and schools? The reason is they could not get any pleasure in so-called Brahma realization. Therefore, they come back to give food to the poor, to open hospital, philanthropy. Therefore, if you stick to Krishna consciousness, you will enjoy blissful, transcendental blissfulness, and then you will not be attracted with this humanitarian work or philanthropic work. Parang dhishtyan nivartate, in the service of the Lord, there are so much pleasure, transcendental pleasure. Just like in the life of Goswamis, we find tattva turnamasi samandalapati saneng sada tuchava bhutva dina ganesako upurunaya kopina kanthasito gopi bhava rasam mritadi lahari kallolamagnau sada vande rupa sanatana uragujigau sri jiva gopal. They gave up their ministerial post tattva turnam asesa mandalapatisane sada tuchava. Most insignificant. They gave up their ministerial post and they become mendicants. Tattvaturnam asesa mandalapatisane sada tuchava bhutva dina ganesa kau karunaya kaupina kanthas. Become very poor, voluntarily mendicant. It is very difficult if one changes his dress artificially by imitating Rupa Goswami. He cannot stay. He'll have to take to sex pleasure and intoxication to keep himself fit for bhajan. No. But the Goswamis, they did not take into sex pleasure or intoxication. They were merged into the ocean of the dealings of the gopis with Krishna. Gopi bhava rasam mritadhi lahari. There is a lahari. There is a flow, constant flow of waves in the ocean of loving affairs between Krishna and the gopis. So they were merged into that. Therefore, this renunciation, this material renunciation did not affect. Otherwise, if one artificially renounces this material world, and he does not get real shelter unto the lotus feet of Krishna, he'll fall down. That's a fact. Arujya prichena param padam tata patanti adha anadita dusmadanga. So if you want to stay attached to the lotus feet of Krishna, then you must always keep yourself busy in the transcendental loving service of Lord. Thank you very much.